acting in a way that took me out of the vibration of love. Learning how I could remove my limited judgments of people and of situations to really stay in a field of loving acceptance and of honoring everyone's own personal journey. So it really became a transformative process where I embodied more of that which had been with me my whole life. I just thought everyone had it as a young child, and it wasn't until I started teaching on the internet and posting videos on YouTube that I realized that my message was of value to other people. For me, it was completely normal. It held no value because I always had it. I didn't realize the value of it. It's like they say, you don't realize the value of something until it's taken away. Well, I didn't realize the value of it until other people started telling me how important my message was to them, how it helped them, how it helped them connect more with their own inner truth. And that's when I really started making these weekly videos on the internet and encouraging people to explore themselves, to understand how the mind works, to understand what's beyond the mind, to understand the energy of love as an actual creative, life-sustaining energy that fills us, that fills our cells, that makes us feel at one with everything. So it's been a process of unfoldment. And as I continued to post these videos, as I continued to spend more time in this field of love, living my daily life, going to work, talking with people and strangers and friends and internet audience, I just began to resonate more and more in this state, and my incarnate vibration harmonized more fully with this universal field of love, with this experience of oneness, and I just keep growing more into that. The field of love is infinite, so there's really no boundary on what we can choose to express here, on how we can choose to live our expression here. Because ultimately, it's us. How are we choosing to live ourselves? How are we choosing to express the I am that I am? And it's all our choice. So that's been a synopsis of the last 6 or 7 years of my life as working directly with this intelligence and sharing the message that comes out of me.
How interesting. You know, as you're talking about that, and thank you for sharing that, I believe it relates somewhat to the idea in mystical traditions of attaining unto the conversation of the holy guardian angel in one system. And in another, I believe it has something to do with the awakening of the actual faculty of the intuition, which really relates to the idea of the inner tutor.
Yeah, that's interesting.
This whole faculty, this being able to receive information from the universal fields of intelligence that surround all of us, mm-hmm. be able to draw to ourselves a conscious understanding of this or that via the great intuitive faculty, which most people think we don't even have anymore. You know, it gets a bunch of poo-poo. Of course, they just try to guess the numbers of the, you know, on the lottery with it. But this faculty, when it can be awakened in a son, daughter of God, becomes a mighty, mighty asset. And is there anything I'm saying here that is there's something more you can do for us to demonstrate this ability?
Oh, sure. It's quite easy for me to get into this conversation, into this flow of communication. Myself, I can do it at any time, in any place. The clarity and the depth of the connection as an energetic experience will vary depending upon who's around or where I'm at. You know, sitting in my own space in my own apartment is a lot different energetically than doing it at the aisleway of a public grocery store. But the information can be accessed nonetheless because this universal field is everywhere. So is there anything particular that you want me to talk on, Charles, or should I just let it flow?
Just let it flow.
All right. Dear ones, you are the love and light of all that is. Never doubt this. Never doubt that you are anywhere else but within the heart of God. For each and every person is a manifestation, a fleck of light existing as the eternal heartbeat of all that is. So, dear ones, as you journey out within this world, always remember the oneness by keeping your attention upon the spiritual heart, the heart that exists within you and extends throughout all eternity. For as you step into this deeper awareness, you will experience and realize that the love within yourself is truly limitless, flowing beyond the confines of any energetic system as a manifest individual form, and flowing into the space that surrounds your being and into the heart and energy field of all that is. For this love, dear ones, is the creative fabric of life, and it is the creative essence of you. There is nothing at all that you can do to separate yourself from this, for you are this, and you have always been this. All that is limiting you, dear ones, is your own belief in limitation, your own belief that you cannot, your own belief that you have not. And as you choose to create this experience of limitation, so too does it manifest in your perception as your own reality. So we encourage you, dear ones, to release the limitation from your own thinking mind and to embrace once again the love that exists all around you, the heaven that has always existed upon this earth and within each and every one of your hearts. And so, dear ones, trust. Trust that this is you. Trust that this has always been, and you will reawaken to the knowing that you have never been separate from life, that you have never been separate from love, that you do not need at all to work towards this experience, that instead you simply need to surrender, to relax and let go, and to allow this energy to open within you, to allow this greater intelligence to become one with your mind, one with your individual expression, and to allow your energy system to reunite once again with the heart of God. For the heart of God is open. The heart of God is you. You simply need, dear ones, to remember this once again and to allow this universal expression of bliss and love to fill your life and to fill the lives of all that exist upon this earth. So was that good, Charlie?
I want to say thank you, God. This is the eternal message.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. It'll never end.
No.
It'll never end. It's always calling us back into a deep realization.
Yeah. Yeah, I've made hundreds of videos, and the essence is always the same.
Oh, that's great. God bless you and your work. By the way, now, if others want to look you up someplace in time and space and find you illuminating their screen, how do they get a hold of you?
I run a few websites.
Bring them up.
My major website is channelhigherself.com, and that website has posted every video that I've made, including my other interviews, including channelings I've done for myself, some that I've done for other friends, as well as a weekly video that I run, and a past video series that I did. A second website, which is my current video series, which is the weekly videos, it's called Satsang, S-A-T-S-A-N-G, SatsangWithTheSelf.com. And that is a weekly internet ashram that I created about 2 years ago. And it is an interactive webcam video chat room where anyone around the world that has access to a webcam video can join in every weekend, and they can see me live, and I can see them. And there's members in the video chat room, and we all get together, and I bring through my weekly message, and afterwards we dialogue about that message or about other questions that they do have about their own life. And
well, that sounds wonderful. This is Satsang with what?
With the Self. Yeah,
wonderful.
Yeah, it's the first internet ashram that fully internet ashram.